final for Floorball 2, John Boy Media's Warehouse Games. You know who it is, McFlurry Power. Take it on, We Got Ice. If you're not familiar, I'm Steve Dangle, and here's my review of the game from my perspective, because I played in it. So, how did we get here? John Boy Media. You know them, you love them from all their baseball breakdowns, a lot of lip reading. Well, now they have an empire of many, many sports channels. And they invited people primarily from around the hockey world to participate in Floorball 2. This is the second year they've done a floorball tournament. And this year, it's teams of four, three players and a goalie. Six teams competed in this thing. Jesse Blake competed on the Love Yous. My team, McFlurry Power. In our first game, we played We Got Ice, who we happened to get in the final, and we very, very, very narrowly beat them. We did not want to play them again. After that, we played Hook, Line, Sinkers. We beat them 11-2. That secured us the one seed through the regular season and into the playoffs. That allowed us to play John Boy, Jimmy O'Brien in the semifinal, and Team Baggage. Again, we had a 3-0 lead. We very, very narrowly hang on. 3-2. He scored with less than a minute left. Clinch. But we clinch our berth in the final. We Got Ice. Goodness, it was a little different for them. First, they lose to us. And holy cow, it was so close. You could very easily argue they were the better team. Then they play against Jesse Blake and Love Yous. They get an early lead, they hold on, they win. Now McFlurry Power, we got a bye through the quarterfinal. We got right to the semifinal. We Got Ice wasn't so lucky, they had to play Love Yous again in the quarterfinal. And once again, they hang on to win. They have to play against Woogas in the semifinal. It goes to overtime, and this is the winner by DZ from Bar Down. It's an incredible goal, man. The hands in tight, under pressure. It's so good. But look at me on the sideline. I happen to be the closest spectator to this goal, and you can see I'm like happy for DZ. He's an awesome guy. Happy for We Got Ice, but also like, we really didn't want to play them again. Dude, it's not like we wanted to play Woogas in the final either. They were extremely good. They had Corwin from Bar Down, but this is how it works out. This is how it was meant to be. We Got Ice versus McFlurry Power in the final. They put on the Ritz for us too. We had the Canadian national anthem for McFlurry Power, the all-Canadian team. We had the American national anthem, which was beautiful. It was beautiful. You'll just have to imagine how beautiful it was. Go to the Warehouse Games page to check it out. Then it's a shootout to decide who gets the game-opening 30-second power play. K-Mac very narrowly closes down all the little holes between his arms, stops Reagan Rust. Nick Bowens gets one for McFlurry Power, so we get the opening 30-second power play. But We Got Ice. They're tight. They're stingy. They didn't give us much. They kill the power play, and to make matters worse, look what I did.
Here comes DZ out of the box. Oh, and here comes K-Mac out of the goal. Oh! And what do we have here? There's a whistle by referee Dan.
Well, yeah. 30 seconds. You're in the box.
Oh no, is that gonna be an early penalty on, is it?
Steve Dangle gets a 30-second penalty for a crease violation.
Wow, you called him with both names. Not just Dangle, you called him out. I don't think his parents are gonna be proud
shame,
of him.
Shame, shame, shame.
Kelsey?
How disappointed are you right now, leading the game off right after you guys just broke the first power play?
During orientation, I was like, I'm going to take so many penalties. And then I was proud of myself for taking none penalties. And now it's the final, and I took a penalty. I'm pretty pissed.
We Got Ice. They're tight. They're stingy. They didn't give us much, and we weren't able to score. And then right after, I take a penalty. You're not allowed as a defensive player to stand in the tiny crease. There's a big crease and a tiny crease. And DZ, who I was worried about, he was a net front presence in the semifinal. He got both of We Got Ice's goals. He forced me into the little tiny box area, the little tiny crease, and I had to sit for 30 seconds. And let me tell you, it was the longest 30 seconds ever! But McFlurry Power, whew, closes the door. Right as I leave the box, We Got Ice immediately goes to the Pavel play. If you don't know what the Pavel play is, Pavel Barber, who was in the broadcast booth, gets to join a team once for 30 seconds in any given game. We took a penalty, we had to kill it for 30 seconds, they had to run around, they got tired, and then they immediately go to the Pavel play. It was a great strategy from We Got Ice. It's exactly what we would have done. Reagan Rust, who is a professional women's player herself, had an incredible chance, luckily, high and wide. We escape again and survive the Pavel play. Now it's time for a Pavel play of our own. Let's fight back a little bit. We had such a close call, but it wasn't meant to be. Pavel shoots it high and wide. It goes off of the end boards, which it's not part of the play. It goes over the boards and out, bounces back in because he shoots like a bullet. Chelsea Dinan puts it in, but it doesn't count because the ball went out of play. And that is how we would head into first intermission, like two boxers feeling each other out in the early rounds of a fight, 0-0. We'll start with this battle between me and DZ. He was so good in front of the net. I wanted to be all over him. I knew I wasn't going to be able to outrun him. He's skinnier. He's in better shape. So I was like, you know what? I'm just going to lean on him. And we just went at each other like two bull elephants. That was just a small clip of it, but that went on all game. And maybe it threw me off my game because look at this giveaway to Reagan Rust. What am I doing?
Ball trickles down. Rust. Just wide and out of bounds.
Oh, she's had a couple great looks today.
Thank goodness I didn't pay for my mistake that time, but very shortly after, Reagan Rust, once again, basically destroys me.
The ball uses the boards.
Comes toe in. Drag!
Oh, great
oh,
move!
Oh, my goodness.
And then runs right over K-Mac.
Dude, do you understand? Like, listen, if we lose, we lose. If we lose, we lose. We're in the final. We're playing a really good team. Fine. It's one thing to lose, but if I flew to New Jersey for 3 days to compete in this tournament just to get my jock dangled off and have us lose that way, I wouldn't be able to forgive myself. So I would like to sincerely thank K-Mac, our goalie, for not allowing a goal there. Now, as we go towards the end of the second period, one of my worst periods at this entire tournament, we catch a break. I took a penalty early in the first period. Late in the second period, I get to draw one. Nick Bowens and I switch a little bit on the attack. He passes it up to me, and I carry the ball into the offensive zone, which I did, I think, zero times in the tournament leading up to this point. And Zoe from We Got Ice slashes me right on the shaft of the stick. You can't do that. It's a 30-second penalty. While we're on the power play, I'm just trying to get open. Chelsea Dinan trying to get open. Nick Bowen's doing everything he can just to take the ball off Reagan Rust. DZ is behind We Got Ice's net. He's trying to be an outlet for Reagan, but Chelsea comes in. Nick keeps the pressure on and eventually takes the ball away himself.
Reagan's just going to eat clock if Bowens doesn't get on her away.
You have to get on her.
You got to get on her, but she'll be happy to spin off him and just keep spinning.
Look at the stick handling.
So good
huh?
at this. Oh, but he seals it.
Bowens, he got it.
Unbelievable.
You can't hear me screaming that video, so can I reenact it?
Stir that shake. A critical penalty by Zoe forced him into the box, and McFlurry power capitalizes.
It's not often that you see Reagan get stripped of the ball and then Bowens between the legs for good measure. How you doing?
Nick Bowens between the legs! Dude, if I'm not mistaken, the shots were relatively even in this game up to this point. They lied. They were liars. We were not close to We Got Ice. I think we generally played pretty good defense. Their defense was every bit as good, and they had way more offense, way more legs, just taking so many more shots. A lot of them missed wide. Part of that is, you know, we're playing good angles, trying to keep everyone wide and everything, but like, they were running us into the ground. We needed something special in a special moment, and Nick Bowens between the legs, filth. And look at the hole that it has to go through. Look at the gap. Look at how close it comes to hitting DZ, comes to hitting Jack Doyle in net for We Got Ice. This so narrowly finds the back of the net, but it finds a way. With the final remaining seconds in the second period, we know we just have to shut it down, and I'm gonna block as many shots as possible. Time winds down. We head to second intermission, up 1-0, 1 5-minute period away from a championship and from a banner in the warehouse. Can we do it, or will we choke like the team that I cheer for always does? They interviewed me during the second intermission, and I want to show it to you because I want to show you what I said and what the truth really was.
What do you think you need to execute better?
We're doing a good job not getting flustered because, you know, chances don't come in abundance when you play a team this fast. We're just sticking to what we do best. For me, that's sticking my ass out and trying to take a ball.
Okay, so I said how we weren't getting flustered. We were. We were getting very flustered at one point during the game. I can't remember when it was because I was breathing out of my buttocks. K-Mac kind of pulls the whole team, me, Nick Bowens, Chelsea Dinnan, all aside. And it's like, hey, like, we're hanging back. Like, we need to get another one, like, to secure this thing. And he's like, what's the matter? Like, are we worried? Are we this? Are we that? And it's like, no, bro. Like, it's not that we're hanging back. They're just killing us. In the baggage game, there was a little bit more, like, energy conservation. There was a little bit more score effects at play. Like, our strategy in that third period was obviously not smart. They outscored us 2-0 in that game, and we almost blew the lead entirely. But you gotta remember, the semifinal and the final were both on the same day. And I guess it worked out this way because we were the one seed. McFlurry Power's semifinal game was before we got ices. So we would have more time to recover from our semifinal game than we got iced in. And even though we were technically more fresh than we got ice, they ran us into the ground. They were running our show. This goes back to how huge that first win against We Got Ice was, the first game of the whole tournament for us both. Earning the one seed was a huge deal for us. And that's why, like, when we allow a goal to make it 11-2 at the end of our second game against Hookline Sinkers, like, K-Mac looks nervous because part of the reason the score got run up, like, we wanted the one seed because we were worried about a situation like this. Thank goodness we got the one seed. Third period starts and it's all We Got Ice. DZ making me break dance in there, and look at how close he comes to scoring.
Turned away. And DZ right in front.
DZ!
Oh, he had another shot. Ball still alive and the ball gets knocked out of bounds. I think that'll be a corner ball for We Got Ice.
Oh, they're saying side of the net?
Really?
From the referee there.
Oh, wow.
But DZ, just so unassuming, but he pops out in little short bursts here.
Dude, we get away with one in more than one regard here. DZ goes for the wraparound, and he's so, so close to scoring a goal. But I get my stick in the way. Would it have gone off the post? Would it have gone off the side of the net if I was never there? I don't know, and we'll never know. I had to reach across the little crease because I didn't want to get another penalty again. But another way that we get lucky here, this ball clearly goes off my stick and out of bounds. It was McFlurry Power ball because they thought DZ was the last one to touch it. It was me. That was a gift that we would throw away later in the period. We'll get there. They're still coming at us in waves. We're trying to wear them down. I block Zoe a couple times, and then there's a shot right off of K-Mac's mask, and look at my reaction. That is how much every single play mattered to us. Then with just over a minute to go in the third, puck goes out of play. It's our ball in our own end, in our own corner. We misplayed the ball on the hit into play, so we turn it over, and now it's We Got Ice getting to hit the ball into play in our own end. I'm battling with DZ in front, again, leaning on each other like a couple bull elephants. Reagan Russ comes running in like a bat out of hell, shoots it on, and it just happens to hit my stick and then me. Lucky, lucky, pure luck. And now, here we go. We're within the final minute of the game, and I want to talk you guys through it as it happens. Full narration. 45 seconds left. Nick Bowens with an inbound pass to me. I give it right back to him. He's going to try to waste as much time as possible. He's on the half wall. He goes for refuge behind We Got Ice's net. They 3-on-1 him. Finally take the ball off him, but he's killed a solid 10 seconds. Here comes Zoe. I block it with my stick. Don't know where it is. I run after it and slow it down. I plant my left ankle so hard, and the pain goes right up my leg and into my mid-back. I've screwed up something, pinched a nerve. I don't know what. They've pulled their goalie. Jack Doyle is out there as the extra attacker. I'm trying to block shots, trying not to draw attention to myself. K-Mac inbounds the ball. I don't realize it. I plant my leg again, and it's hurting every single time I put weight on it. I block a shot. We clear it. They try to bring it back in. Nick Bowens with the block. Final attempt at a shot. No good. McFlurry power wins. I drop to my knees immediately and I feel like I screwed up the celebration. Dude, I'm so serious. Right under, like right on the outside of my left ankle, right under the bone. I don't know what I did. I planted funny. The pain immediately shot up my leg. You can see me react right away. And I'm trying not to draw attention to it because I'm like, they're gonna zero in on me if they realize I'm hurt. But when the ball went into the corner, because I was looking at the clock or something off screen, I planted it so hard again. And at that point, I'm like, dude, I can't even push off this thing. So I just go into ultimate shot blocker mode because that was all I could be, was basically just a shield in the final few seconds. I know that's all we gotta kill. That's all we gotta kill. And we were able to do it. The confetti poppers go off and Jesse Blake, I love you so much, buddy. He comes right after me, giving me, like, messing up my hair, congratulating me. He was, like, almost happier than I was. He couldn't believe that I won. And if you look in the celebration, right after I give him my glasses, I'm like, dude, my ankle. I'm so screwed up. Now, thankfully, I ended up being okay. Like, as soon as it happened, and after that second plant when I went into the corner, I was like, this is gonna be a problem. This is gonna be a problem for at least a month. I will say this, from that day forth, my ankle has always clicked. This was like 2-3 months ago. It doesn't cause me any pain though, thankfully. And after 5-10 minutes, I was fine after this. So, how did we win? Dude, I have no idea. Beating We Got Ice the first time in the regular season, it's like the Miracle on Ice speech. If we play them 10 times, they might win 9. But then what if Team USA had to play Russia twice? If we play them 20 times, they might win 18. Like, we were outmatched. We were. I don't know if we were in the first game. I think we were. We were definitely outmatched in the second game. And it was just Nick's ability to make something truly special happen. We blocked a ton of shots. We tried our best to take away the angles, make them rush, and K-Mac in net. K-Mac. Unbelievable K-Mac. If you want to apply hockey analytics to how McFlurry Power won floorball 2, we rode a PDO bender. And that's kind of the quantifier for luck. In terms of shooting percentage, the amount of shots on goal that actually found their way into the back of the net, there were two teams tied for second at 20%. Baggage scored on 20% of their shots on goal, and Woogas had 20% of their shots on goal go in. Our team, McFlurry Power, scored on 30% of the shots that we had on net. I only had 8 shots on net in 4 games. 2 of them went in though, so I shot 25%, and that was the worst on the team. Nick Bowens, 23 shots on net, 7 of them went in. Chelsea Dinnan, 19 shots on net, 6 of them went in. So I was 25%, Bowman's was 30%, Chelsea Dinnan, 32. She was unbelievable. And this tournament had some great goalies, but statistically, K-Mac was the best goalie in the tournament by a mile. Sales Lucas DeVersa, was the second best goalie in the tournament by save percentage, stopping 81.5% of the shots he faced. K-Mac, 90.6. K-Mac allowed just 6 goals in 4 games, made 58 saves. The next closest goalie, 34. Dalton Feely of Love Yous. K-Mac was, to me, the MVP. But it could have easily been Chelsea. It could have easily been Nick Bowens. Dude, we had a great team that just did their part. Nick kind of was our, like, midfielder, like, kind of rover. Just hustled on defense and made plays happen on offense. Chelsea Dinnan was an assassin out there. Truly unbelievable, just making things happen offensively. I just tried to get in the way as often as possible, and I was so little of a factor offensively that anytime I did jump up on offense, it surprised people and led to good things. And K-Mac, baby. Sweet, sweet K-Mac. And now that is it for the tournament. There is going to be a post-game video uploaded tomorrow to the Warehouse Games YouTube channel, where there's going to be interviews and stuff like that. And then I believe in about a week's time, I think November 16th, there will be an awards show. Final thoughts from me. you could tell by how I've been treating this tournament that this meant a lot to me. It did. It did. Like, I know it's not, like, professional sports. I don't care. It meant a lot to me to win this. I know I'm not in the greatest shape. I know I'm not. I used to be in pretty decent shape. And I've talked about it on the podcast. I've screwed my back up so many times. When we had a COVID baby in summer of 2020, I injured my back like I had never done before. I was feeding him bottles in the middle of the night from my knees because it hurt to sit. It's been over 2, going on 3 years of solid work every week with a trainer just to get to a point where I'm comfortable. Like, I'm not having to do an hour of body maintenance every day. So when I got asked to be in this tournament, I'm like, dude, I don't know if my body's gonna hold up. And that might sound pathetic, given that, you know, this isn't exactly the National Hockey League, but I don't care. I'm so proud that I was able to make it through those 4 games in those 3 days. And to win it is the ridiculous cherry on top. On my way there, flying there with Jesse Blake, we flew Porter Airlines. And if you know that, you know that they give out cans of Steam Whistle beer. On the way there, I didn't have a beer. And I made a point to myself to not have a beer. Because no, you're going into this tournament, you can have a beer after you win, is what I told myself, jokingly. When we won, I got onto the plane, and folks, I kept the can because it's the most satisfying beer I've ever had in my entire life. This was on a flight. Like, look how good condition. I cannot believe it made it home in this good condition. I gotta put it away, I gotta protect it. Please follow all of my teammates on social media. Nick Bowens, one of the guys who heads up the Hockey Collective on Instagram. Chelsea Dinnan is Dream Hockey on Instagram. She's got crazy hands. K-Mac, former Yankees prospect. Kyle McDonald, he does all sorts of stuff with John Boy, and I know this meant a lot to him. And hey, if you're not subscribed to me, why don't you do that? But for now, that is it for this one. Thank you very much for watching. Click like if you liked this video. Click subscribe if you really liked it. Tell all your friends. Set your mind to a goal.